Welcome to experiment 4th of electrical machine lab. In this lab, the experiment that we are going to perform is basically the load test on DC series motor. So let us see the theory behind the experiment. The objective is to conduct the load test on what? DC series motor. So series motor is the one where the field winding is connected in series with the armature, and we have to find the efficiency of the motor. So efficiency we need to find. Now the motor that we are going to use in the lab is basically having the kilowatt rating of 3.5 kilowatt. Its voltage is 220 volt. Current is 18.6 ampere. That is the rated current of the machine. We should not exceed the current of 18.6 ampere. Speed is 1500 rpm. So this is the rated speed of the machine. Excitation current, the current required to produce the flux is 0.95 ampere, and the winding is of series type. The resistance of the armature is 0.8 ohms and the series field resistance is 174 ohms. The breakdown radius is 0.1 meter. So we will be using voltmeter, ammeter and tachometers. So voltmeter is basically having a range of 300 volts and ammeter is having a range of 20 ampere, and the tachometer is basically can measure a speed up to 2000 rpm. So all are of digital mode. Then if we see the circuit diagram for the load test, so here we see that the series field winding is connected in series with the armature of the machine. So this is the armature, and here you have, this is the armature and this is the field winding. So it is connected in series, and we required a starter to restrict the heavy starting current that is flown in the machine at the starting. So we have three terminals in the starter. One is the line terminal, one is armature terminal, and one is the neutral terminal. The line terminal goes with the supply, the armature terminal goes with the armature, and the neutral terminal is connected to the neutral or the ground of the machine. So we required a voltmeter and ammeter to measure the voltage and the current which is drawn from the supply. So the supply is basically 220 volt DC supply, which is given through a DPST switch, and there is a fuse which restricts the over current protection. Now, since it is a motor, the mechanical load is given with the help of a brake drum whose weight can be measured in terms of the kg with using the two springs S1 and S2 connected with the brake drum. Now, the theory behind this experiment is to determine the performance of a DC machine, which is largely influenced by which the field winding is excited. So basically the field winding can be connected in the form of a shunt, that is where the field is connected in parallel with the armature, and you have the series field where the field winding is connected in series with the armature. In shunt field, large number of turns of thin wire are used, whereas in the series field we are basically using few turns of heavy gauge wire. So there is a difference between how the field winding is owned to produce the flux. So basically the use of the field winding is to produce the flux which is necessary for the performance, for the rotation of the machine. Now we see that when the field winding is connected in series with the armature, then the equation of the back EMF we can write as terminal voltage minus the total drop in the resistance of the armature plus the series resistance. And we also know that the induced EMF E is proportional to the flux and the speed of the machine. So what is happening when the armature current becomes zero? Because under the light load condition, so under the light load condition, the motor will not draw any amount of the current. So if the motor is not drawing any amount of the current, so basically the flux becomes zero, because when you have the series winding, current is zero, it means the flux is zero. Hence, if the flux is zero and we know that speed will be directly proportional to E by phi, so if you make the flux to be zero, the speed will be tremendously high. So it means the speed is running up to infinity. Hence, DC series motors should never be allowed to run at no load condition, even accidentally. So you should not turn on the DC series motor under the no load condition, because if you turn on the motor under the no load condition, what will happen? The current drawn by the machine will be very small and the speed will run to infinity. Hence, we should always put some amount of load before we start the DC series motor. Also, the torque, if you see, the torque is proportional to flux and armature current, and where the flux is produced due to armature current itself, so we can say that torque is proportional to square of the armature current. It means that a small amount of change of the armature current will produce a heavy amount of change in the torque. So we have to just change the armature current slowly so that the large torque is not produced in the machine. Also, DC series motor application, if we see, it is used to drive heavy load, because when we change a small amount of current, heavy torque is produced. So this is the setup that we are going to use in the lab to perform the experiment, where the, this is the field winding which can be connected to the armature of the DC motor in series, and we have a different digital instrument which is there, which is a voltmeter, ammeter, to measure the voltage, current and the speed. We have a tachometer, and this is the starter. This is starter which restrict the flow of the heavy current at the starting. We have the terminal line, armature and neutral, and this is the MCB, and we have a series motor. So these two springs we change to change the load on the machine. So we have a 3.5 kilowatt 220 volt 1500 RPM setup to perform this experiment. So some precautions we need to take, that motor should be started and stopped with load condition only. So a small amount of load should always be there, otherwise the speed will be tremendously high. So brake drum should be cooled with water when the motor is loaded. So what is happening when the motor is under the loaded condition and it is running, it gets heated up. So a small amount of water should be poured in a small instant of time in the drum, in the rotating shaft, so that when the motor is rotating, it just cool down. Do not exceed the full load current. So we see that the rating current of the motor is 18.6 ampere. So we should not cross the full load current, otherwise the winding will burn. Do not exceed the rated speed also. So if the rated speed is 1500 RPM, so we should not exceed that particular speed of the motor. Now, we will perform the connections. So having given the connection, we have to connect the armature and the field winding in series, and we have to connect the voltmeter in parallel and ammeter in series with the supply, and we have to connect the starter, that is the line, neutral and armature, with the appropriate terminals of the armature. So there are two slip spring, S1 and S2, that has to be varied using this knob so that the load on the motor changes. Then after doing the connection, some procedure is there that we need to follow. So whether first thing we have to check whether proper circuit diagram we have followed to do the connection, and check whether the motor is sufficiently loaded around 50%, otherwise the motor will be running at tremendously high speed. So once we apply the load by tightening the belt, you note down the reading of voltmeter, ammeter and the speed with the tachometer, and do not exceed the speed of the rated speed, and just note down the radius of the drum and then do the calculations. So here the observation table is, we have to measure the voltage, input current, what is the difference of the weight that we have put in the S1, S2 in kgs, the speed in RPM, the torque in Newton meter, and we have to do these calculations. So this is the calculations, and these are the measurement that we have to do. So here we have the measurement and here we have the calculation. So how do we do the calculation? So first you note down what is the radius of the drum from the nameplate rating, and then we have to do the calculation, like we need to find the torque, input power, output power and the efficiency. We know that the torque is basically S1 minus S2, that is the weight multiplied with the radius of the drum into 9.81, that is the acceleration due to gravity, that unit will be in Newton meter. Similarly, the input power is basically the product of the voltage and the current in the input, and the output power, we know that power is basically omega into torque. So omega we here is basically 2 pi n, that is the speed of the machine, and T is the torque. So we divide with 60 to convert into RPM. So efficiency is basically what is the output power by input power multiplied with 100 to convert it into percentage. Then we have to plot some graph, that is the percentage efficiency versus output power, the torque versus output power, and the speed versus output power. So the model graph has been shown how the graph will be there of the torque and the speed and the induced efficiency of the machine. So we then finally the result has to be written, what is the efficiency of the DC series motor which is shown, and the torque and the speed graph has to be plotted against the output power. At the end of the experiment, you should be able to answer the following questions: that why can't a series motor be started at no load condition? Why does the DC series motor have a high starting torque? Why does a DC series motor have a very high speed regulation? How is speed control through field control achieved in a DC series motor? Write down the different ways of doing the same. So how do you control the speed of the DC series motor using field control? Write down the advantage and disadvantage of DC series motor. So what are the advantage and disadvantage? So one disadvantage is that we should not start the DC series motor under the no load condition. An advantage is that the torque is very high for the DC series motor. Even a small change in the current will produce a high amount of the torque. So write down the difference between the shunt and the series field winding. So we have seen that how the field winding is connected with the armature in the form of the shunt and the series. So you need to find the difference. And state two applications of a DC series motor. So having known the performance, we can be able to state what are the applications of the DC series motor when we apply. So this experiment focus on the DC series motor and calculating its performance in terms of the efficiency. So thank you for now.